Christian Akia for Insight Media. It's Display Week 2024. I'm in the PlayNitride booth. They develop microLED displays based on three backplanes: PCB, TFT, LTPS on glass, and silicon. So let's start with their PCB demo they're showing here this year. This is a cubed type display. As you can see, it's got displays on all six sides here. And the details on this are as follows. First of all, this is composed of a number of LED packages, micro LED packages. So each package is 1.1 by 1.1 millimeters. That has within that package is a 4x4 array of RGB micro LEDs. These are flip chip micro LEDs that are in the 15 by 30 micron range, and it's all packaged as a flip chip device, which can now be used by SMT type manufacturing processes. So this is very compatible with the way digital signage and video wall LED modules are put together today. That's the whole point of this. But because this is fairly bright, it can go, this one is actually 3,000 nits, but they can go actually up to 30,000 nits because it's passive matrix, which means they can drive it harder. That also means that you have to have a separate driver chip, just like you do in normal video wall applications. Let's see. Second of all, they are going to work on trying to shrink the pixel pitch. The pixel pitch right now is about, it says it's 0.33 for a 76 ppi, but they said they're working on to get that down to 0.5 millimeters, so I'm a little confused on what they were saying then. But this, the resolution of each of these displays is 240 by 240. This is their TFT LCD backplane for the micro LEDs. So this is a box situation here. You can see the micro LED in front here, it's transparent. And there's a little car model in back of that. But what's unique about this configuration, the first time this has been shown, is that they also have bonded, there you go, it's a blocking layer. So in order to create that transparency, that opaqueness rather, for the transparent display, they bonded an LCD cell in back of it. This could be a single cell LCD, which it kind of looks like in this case, or it could be multi-zonal. But this allows the transmissivity to vary from 1% to 40%. So this is the fully blocked now. So we're looking at basically it's almost like watching an opaque display, which is kind of nice. The 40% on the transmissivity side is a little low. I think you want to get higher than that for practical applications. But this is an interesting demo to start with here. This particular panel is a 9.38 inch transparent micro LED display. Resolution is 960 by 480 with a 0.22 millimeter pitch. That's 1.114 ppi. Now let's look at their CMOS. In this area, PlayNitride is highlighting their manufacturing process. You start with the three different epi wafers, red, green, and blue. You transfer those onto a intermediate carrier, which they call chip-on-carrier 1. And those then get transferred to a second carrier. So this chip-on-1 is kind of like tape or something of the sort. And it gets transferred to a larger carrier, a chip-on-2, CLNC-2. And then they can also make this this package. This is the that small package I was talking about, what they had in that cube display. And here's some of the wafers that you can see here. They're also showing over here. This is an update for their 0.49 inch micro LED micro display, good for AR applications. They've shown this for a couple of years now. It's this 0.49 inch device. They say they're getting a 99% yield out of it, which is quite good. It's full HD resolution. It's quantum dot color converted using photolithography. So last year, the brightness was about 150,000 nits. This year, they pushed it up to 300,000 nits. Color gamut is good, but again, like everyone, they spec this as 100% of NTSC, which I find to be a very unattractive way of talking about color gamut. But that story here from PlayNitride, Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.